if we offend, it is with our goodwill. That you should think we come not to offend, but with goodwill. To show our simple skill, that is the true beginning of our end. Our true intent is all for your delight. The actors are at hand, and by their show you shall know all that you are like to know.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Sonnet 18 by William Shakespeare. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometime declines, by chance or nature's changing course and trend. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose thy possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines to time thou growest. So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe. It was many and many a year ago in the kingdom by the sea that a maiden there lived whom you may know by the name of Annabel Lee. And this maiden she lived with no other thoughts than to love and be loved by me. I was a child and she was a child in this kingdom by the sea, but we loved with a love that was more than love. I and my Annabel Lee. With the love that the winged seraphs of heaven coveted her and me. And this was the reason that long ago in this kingdom by the sea, a wind blew out of a cloud, chilling my beautiful Annabel Lee. So that her high-born kinsmen came and bore her away from me, to shut her up in a sepulchre in this kingdom by the sea. The angels, not half so happy in heaven, went envying her and me. Yes, that was the reason, as all men know in this kingdom by the sea, that the wind came out of the cloud by night, chilling and killing my Annabel Lee. But our love, it was stronger by far than the love of those who were older than we, of many far wiser than we. And neither the angels in heaven above nor the demons down under the sea can ever dissever my soul from the soul of the beautiful Annabel Lee. For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabel Lee, and the stars never rise, but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabel Lee. And so, all the night tide, I lay down by the side of my darling, my life and my bride, in her sepulchre there by the sea, in her tomb by the sounding sea.
Sonnet 17 by William Shakespeare. Who will believe my verse in time to come, if it were filled with your most high desert? Though yet heaven knows it is but a tomb, which hides your life and shows not half your part. If I could write the beauty of your eyes, and in fresh numbers number all your graces, the age to come would say this poet lies, such heavenly touches never touched earthly faces. So should papers yellowed with their age be scorned, like old men of less truth than tongue, and your true rights be turned a poet's rage and stretched meter of an antique song. But were some child of yours alive that time, you should live twice, in it and in my rhyme.
This is a poem by my husband, Bill Hines, called A Useful Wife. It used to be the role of my wife each night to give me the thrill of my life. But now that we are over our hills, she just reminds me to take all my pills.
Norman, isn't it exciting? The loons are teaching their baby to fly.
Listen to this. Retired people needed for handbell delivery. Some walking required. I should call. I can walk.
Is that why you came back here? To read those gosh darn ads?
I'll tell you why I came back so fast. I went to the end of our lane, and I could not remember how to find the old town road. I walked a little bit into the woods, and nothing was familiar. Not one damn tree. It scared the heck out of me. And I ran back to see you, to see your pretty face, and to feel safe, and to feel like me.
You're safe, you old poop. And you're definitely still you. Still picking on poor old Charlie. Norman, after lunch, after we've gobbled all the strawberries, we'll take ourselves to the old town road and we'll remember it, my darling. We've walked it 1,000,000 times. And you listen to me, mister. You're my knight in shining armor, and don't you forget it. We're going to get back on that horse, and I'll be right behind you, holding on tight. And away we'll go, 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 go.
I don't like horses. You really are a pretty old dame, aren't you? But why are you with a dotty old SOB like me?
I haven't the vaguest idea.
This is a poem written by Bill Hines that I found just unexpectedly on our 30th anniversary. It's called Dawn Song. As I look around my life everywhere, I see evidence of my wife, decorating all in sight, living life with all her might. When I open my eyes, I see what a treasure she is to me. She brightens up the world I see, but her love's not just for me. She makes the world a better place by offering her charm and grace. Orchids, robins to fill my world, a Veda to make my hair curl. Saturday morning makes her bloom. She has a radio in every room, and I still do today. Her prayer partners all receive gifts and love to help them believe. Her secret pals all have in store her ingenuity and more. Young and blonde and wrinkle-free, she doesn't look as old as me. Cohen quaffed my household queen, and then she uses all those creams. Adding to what I have said, she is also good in church. She always tells me what to do, gets us into something new. I look outside and see her lurk. She's trying to find me more work. Like magic makes a rabbit appear, without my knowledge, I volunteer. In all these things, I'm just the spouse, 'cause she's the president of the house. believe in her to make it known that she is the queen of our home. All in all, she never fails, takes care of all of my details. Rein me in lest I say criticism aimed her way. To praise my love is my intent. With this note, my heart is sent. To Dawn, who decorates my world, from her husband, who has a curl right in the middle of his forehead.
I know you belong to somebody new, but tonight you belong to me. Although we're apart, you're a part of my heart, but tonight you belong. Down by the stream, how sweet it will seem once more just to dream in the moonlight. My honey, I know with the dawn that you will be gone, but tonight you belong.
We shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended, that you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear. Now to scape the serpent's tongue, we will make amends ere long, else this wain a liar call. So good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Main Street Theater shall restore amends.
Happy Valentine's Day from Main Street Theater.
Love from Main Street Theater.
Our hearts and souls go out to you, Tucker.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Main Street Theater loves Tucker. Happy Valentine's Day.
We love you, Tucker.
Happy Valentine's Day from Main Street Theater. We love you.
Happy Valentine's Day from the Lukens.
Happy Valentine's Day with love from Main Street Theater.
Hey, Tucker, who loves you, baby?
We do.
Happy Valentine's Day.